No, no, you gotta, you put it on, Ron. Just move that up here.
What?
Just move that up on your tie or something.
Goes like this, right?
Nope, you wanna move it up to your tie. Yeah.
So, I've been doing this for about 10 years now. Ever since I was a preteen, I think. And this is something that I'm really passionate about. And I'm lucky that I realized early on that, you know, this was my destiny. It's basically the whole neighborhood relying on me. You know, if I don't do my job, the whole system, the whole community, chaos. At the end of the day, I'm just happy that I can help out while doing something that I love.
Wait, what was it that you do again?
I deliver flyers.
What, cut?
What's going
on?
Yeah,
just hold on one sec.
Sorry. Did I do something?
1 second, sorry.
Was there anything?
No, we're on timeout. Okay, 1 sec, we're cutting. What did you say you do again?
I deliver flyers.
This whole time you told me this was a business. This documentary is on small town businesses. Like, what the hell is going on here?
Hey, can we talk for a second? So, we already paid for the time slot, I know. And my mom kind of promised her I'd be at the house until 6 because her boyfriends are coming over. And I really don't want to be near any of that. So, we really got to keep it going.
Yeah, but this isn't what we planned for, so man. I'm just going to cut it here.
Yeah, but I you got to do me a solid. Like, relationships, it's been really on the rocks lately.
Why are you
like,
bringing all this personal... what are you...
We need to keep it going. I can't be there.
This whole thing started with my coworker slash life partner, Nigel. Okay, for a while there, it was just me and him. You know, it seems like ages ago that we were just... kids just hanging out outside and doing stuff. But really, it was our common interest in rollerblading that unified us. And now we have an intensely successful relationship. Business relationship together. It's great that we're able to take this and make it into a sustainable profession. We get hired by small businesses that are looking to start off. And that's great too because we're able to help each other out. And we get paid like 10 bucks a day, which is dope. Okay, easy money. Blading doesn't even feel like a job most of the time. To me, it's more of a lifestyle. Like a way of living, like a way of life, you know what I mean?
What's going on in here?
Oh.
Chester, who are these people?
Oh, sorry, we're just filming a thing.
Get out of my office.
Okay. Sorry.
Lord. Chester, how many times do I have to tell you cannot just come and set up shop in my office?
Okay, sorry, we're just using it as for the Bladers documentary.
No,
so.
Listen, I've told you 10 times already, and like, how did you even get a key to get in here?
So, Nigel's dad kicked us out of the office, which kind of sucks, but we do most of our work in here, so you guys can just come in if you want. So welcome to my humble abode. Hey, check out this nice poster. That's me and Nigel's logo. Made it in Photoshop myself, which is great. So we're just going to go down here, right? Watch your step, there are stairs here. So Nigel's dad, he's in a bitter mood, eh? Kicking us out of his office. I think I know why, too. It's because Nigel left us, him, by going off to school in Guelph. I hate that. You know why? Because he's left me here alone to run a business. You know how tedious this is? It sucks. I gotta sort through flyers. I gotta take them out of packages and wrap them up and stuff like that.
This always happens to me, man.
And I have so many confirmation emails to send. And it takes me hours. Because I can't type as well as Nigel.
Frank, how do you make it caps again?
And to make matters worse, it's winter.
To my knee. You should not sneak up on me like that. Gosh.
Yeah, so basically I'm going to take you guys out for a bit of a ride along today. Show you the neighborhood and stuff, but I'll let you know that things could probably get sour at any moment, so you guys got to stick close. Right? Helmet?
Yeah, helmet. Do you wear a helmet?
No, I don't. I don't wear helmet. No, I don't want to look like an idiot when I'm out there blading. Helmets are for dweebs and bikers. One and the same. Oh, watch out for these stairs. They're the worst. This song's Nectar Man. Okay, a real anthem. Nigel's favorite, actually. I shouldn't take this stuff with me blading, right? I'll just give it back to you then.
All right, peace out.
Hold on, Zach.
Okay. I thought you said you don't fall.
No, I don't fall. This is the freaking first time it's ever happened to me, okay? Ugh.
Hey, you okay? Back there? Are you crying?
No.
He's gonna help you out.
No, he's not. Just close the door. Is it bad? It's bad, isn't it? Oh! You can't just fire after everything we've done for you. You can't just fire us. We've been doing this for 5 months. Jerry, all you have to understand is that I can change. We can both change. Look, you can't just do this to me, man. No, don't wait. Don't hang. on, man. Not cool.
Yo, what's going on?
Hi, nothing really.
Tell me what's up. What's up?
Okay, so actually a lot is up. We got put down today.
What?
We got put down today.
Do you know why?
Well, I was talking to him on the phone, and he's like, you're not efficient, you're useless, you're not cool, and he's replacing us with the bikers. With Luke.
Luke. As in Luke the biker.
Luke the heckin' idiot biker.
Do they not know that we have more wheels than them?
I was trying to...
leg power.
I was trying to tell them. I was trying to tell them that.
Okay, so listen.
Okay.
You take something. I don't know what it can be, but you just take anything. You pop their tires.
Oh, like a sharp thing.
Sharp thing, you pop their tires. Problem solved.
But wouldn't that just impede them for, like, a little bit?
Okay, well, no, not really. I've done this, like, lots of times.
So, that's...
Okay, for instance, let me just give you something. Okay, one time I was sitting on a bench.
Yeah.
Some freaking cyclist cycled by me.
Yeah.
And I gave him the middle finger.
Oh, can you believe that? This guy, I love you, man. That's awesome.
Talk about mental impeachment, right?
I know, it's like, screw you, idiot. That's what I would. Yeah, that's what I would do.
He biked off, and he
probably never came back, right? Probably never saw him again.
No.
So that's great. That's great. Best advice of the day, right there.
I mean, you could try that.
No, I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna freaking break their bikes.
Well, you know. We don't want, like, too much to happen. Just, the tires are okay. Tires are good.
Okay, yeah, I'll pop.
Shut up.
Sorry.
Is that my robe?
What? Your robe?
I see. Is that my robe? It's blue.
Don't hang up. That's not where popping his tires.
So, the plan is to stealthily make our way over to Luke's house, avoiding the street lamps, obviously. I'm not quite sure how far it is. This is down a couple of streets and stuff.
Wait, what happened to your arm?
Oh, I heard it. You were there.
No. Like, why is it bandaged like that?
I had to wrap it because my mom said it looked pretty bad. So I went to the doctor's. Actually, I just wrapped it myself. So, the plan is, once we reach the objective, we need to infiltrate the garage, locate the target, and neutralize it with this. I've slain many enemies with this blade. It's actually Nigel's, but the school didn't allow him to take it. They probably don't like Lord of the Rings, I guess. Operation Screw Luke. Here's a go. Alright, let's go.
Oh, wait, hold on. There we go.
Oh, man. I think you guys can meet me there. It's this street. Yeah, there's four cars in the driveway. You can just give me a sec, right? I'll just meet you there. You just go. Oh, there's no guard dog. Yes. Shoot, the store opens out. That's gonna be harder than I thought.
Yeah, so we weren't allowed to show this whole breaking in part, I guess. For what they tell me, for obvious reasons. The back door was open, which was good. Then we just kind of walked in, so.
Oh my goodness.
Yo, there. there's literally so many bikes in here. I guess I'll just have to pop all of them.
Did you pop my tires?
No, that wasn't me.
Okay.
So, the tire popping was a success. Kind of. Jerry called me back just now, and he said that I can finish off Luke's job while he gets new tires. So that kind of worked, but you know, honestly, I'd rather be rollerblading in the summer. Anyway, winter sucks. It's not fun. I'll just get new clients and...
Chester!
Nigel! What's up? I thought you had school, man. I thought you had class.
Hate it. Worst week of my life.
6 days, but I wasn't counting.
Shut up. You hear that? Shut up. Is that my robe? You're wearing my robe? Why are you still wearing my robe?
It's not gonna pick up.
It's a mental impeach.
Okay, so... It's so hard not to laugh. Oh, jeez. See, I told you that's what he would do.
Sorry, I was trying to... Okay, never mind. I can't really, like... Okay, fine.
You can't what? Did you get that? Are you filming?
Yeah.
Ew! Throw this out!